Hello everyone, Treecks here, and welcome back to Super Metroid. This is going to be part 2. Last time we found ourselves back on Planet Zebes because our baby Metroid got stolen from the researchers of the Federation, and unfortunately they fled back to this place where the very first Metroid game took place. And apparently the space pirates are simply going to try again. But anyway, we got ourselves a new weapon last time. The morph ball bombs. As you can see, we go in morph ball mode, press X to lay bombs. And of course, the famous morph ball jump also returns by doing this, laying those bombs in such a way where you can bounce yourself upwards. Neat little trick, and in some cases even required to use. So keep that trick in mind, even though you should already have it in your mind, since it's a returning trick. It's one that in the first Metroid game was also used in some cases. There you also use it. And of course the morph ball bomb is also used in order to get ourselves out of here. And that same morph ball bomb is also going to be used in order to progress even further into Planet Zebes. Because without the morph ball bombs we are once again at a dead end. But this little corridor over here, as you can see on the map, there's actually something behind here to the left. We can bomb that with our newly acquired bombs, so we can continue our quest. Let's see where this corridor takes us. Okay. A couple of simple enemies around. Kill them for goodies if you are running low on one of them, either missiles or energy. Or you can just simply kill them just because for the fun of it. But you don't really have to. You can ignore the enemies if you're able to avoid them. But for some reason it just feels right killing them. It's a video game after all. Anyway, here we have our next pickup. Also returning from the other Metroid games. The energy tanks. You grab these to increase your energy counter with 100 points. As you can see to the top left, we now have a little pink dot above our energy, indicating we have 100 extra units of energy. So basically our energy count is 199 now, instead of just 99. So we can live a little bit longer if we get hit by something. Okay, here we have green Zebesians, the green space pirates. These guys are immune to our power beam, as you can see. They simply block it. So these guys you actually have to kill with missiles. They're a little bit stronger, but they're not indestructible. We can still kill them. And I want to go in here, but I don't have enough missiles, because you need 5 missiles. And through the magic of video editing, now I have 5 missiles. Let's go check this place out. I can't skip this one, because this one is important. It is not on the map, as you can see. There's no blue rooms here. So, and the music stops here. What is behind door number 1? I am curious. Ah, the gold statue room. Remember in the very first Metroid game where Mother Brain's base of operations was protected by the life force of her commanders, Ridley and Crate? Apparently that has returned, only this time we can recognize Crate here to the left and Ridley up top. But there are 2 more. In the middle we have Fantoon, and to the right we have Dragon. Yeah, it's a Super Nintendo game. We don't have to defeat 2 bosses this time. It's expanded to 4. It's a bigger game. But once again, this fact returns. This is where the Space Pirate base is hidden. But before we can get in there, we apparently need to once again, like in the first game, get rid of her generals. The life force of these guys is protecting that new Torian, you might say. That is apparently our goal here. Find the generals of the space pirates that have been scattered across Planet Zebes. 2 of them return from the first game, Crate and Ridley. There's 2 new ones as well. Let's go find them. Right now we are at the elevator to Brinstar, the real Brinstar, not the little area that is supposed to represent that's the starting area of the first game. Let's get into Brinstar proper this time. Okay, we return to Brinstar. I love what they've done with the place here. Like you might expect, Brinstar is not entirely the same as it was in the first game. It's a lot bigger, first of all. There's more memory in this game, so they were able to make this place a lot bigger. So they did. But okay, we have done the intro of this game, you might say by this point. Now it really gets started. The exploring of the planet is going to start here in Brinstar. Let's go in this room first. There's a couple of things we can pick up here. First of all, there's a refill room here. This is a pipe with infinitely spawning enemies. So if you want to farm for missiles or energy, you can use these guys to do so. But other than that, we are going to want to go up here. And try to run across here. And you will find out you are not able to get through this room entirely. But we can grab this missile expansion. There's a silly little gate present there that blocks our way. We cannot run fast enough before it closes. So this missile tank is the only thing we can pick up for now. We're going to have to come back with better equipment later in order to finish this room. But we do have a little bit more missiles now. Let's go check the other side now. Another red door is present here. Ooh, side hoppers. These guys return. Still nothing too special. All enemies we can kill with simple power beam shots or missiles. In this room we find another map station. This is the map station for Brinstar. Let's download that immediately so we can see what we're dealing with here. Okay, welcome to Brinstar. You can see the purple areas, the areas we've been through. This is the area we went through after the old Torian, where we got the morph ball and the missile tank. And this is basically Brinstar. And take note on that skull sign you see all the way in the room to the right. Those icons is what you're going to want to work with. Those icons are the locations of the four generals of the space pirates. Yep, the map actually gives away where they are. That does not mean that it's easy to reach them, because you might see on the map, hey, there are no rooms connecting that area to this one. And it's like I said, the map does give you a good indication of where you need to go and how the area looks, but it does not show off everything in the area. There's a lot of hidden rooms and hidden corridors that don't show up on the map. And those we need to find in order to get ourselves to the areas we want. Okay, let's go in here. The map shows it as an S room, and S rooms are safe rooms. Enter this little thing to save your game. It does not heal your energy. It's not like your ship, where if you enter that, it also heals your energy. It only saves your game, so use it for that. Okay, this area over here, you can bump this area to see that there's a couple of weird little blocks here. Keep those in mind. You can clearly see we cannot break them open now, but there's an icon on top of them showing that there is something that can break them. It's just something we don't possess right now. Okay, this area actually has some of these fireflies, you might say. If you kill them, as you can see, the room becomes a little bit darker. If you kill all of them, the room becomes entirely dark, so please don't kill all of them, otherwise you won't be able to see where you're going. And here we find a recharge station, in this case for your ammunition. The missile reload completed. Find these little areas to fully heal your missiles. Also returning from Metroid 2, they were present there as well. Not really needed right now, I think. Usually this early on in the game, you usually don't use that many missiles yet, so usually also rarely run out of them. And simple enemy grinding can get you up to your max quickly. But later in the game, when the missile counts start going into the hundreds, and enemies become tougher, so you're going to use them a lot more, It is easier to run out of them and harder to restock them by normal enemy means, so usually those recharge stations become a little bit more valuable then. But at least let me show you off where they are. Okay, these Shriek Batch we cannot destroy, as you can see, so let's just kill them. Let them kill themselves. Okay, welcome to the pink room, what I always call it here in Brinstar. Basically, right in the middle of Brinstar. It's one of the larger rooms here. I always call it the pink room. So for future reference, if I say the pink room, this is the place I mean. And of course, there's a couple of things for us to get here. There's a lot of side rooms here and there. This being one of them, all the way at the top left. A safe room. Not really necessary to save here, but might as well show it off. So, since I'm here, I'm also going to save. Okay, let's get back to our mission. First, we want to go in here, to the top right of the pink room. Let me refill my missiles, because I need missiles where I'm going. Come on. Give me back my missiles. I don't want energy. Okay, one more. Thank you. Let's get in here. Ah, we have key hunters. The insect enemies that can fly around and try to attack you. If you hit them enough, they lose their wings and they become ground enemies. They can, of course, still hurt you, but just be careful for them. It can be quite annoying this early in the game. Definitely the hardest enemies we've seen so far. And yeah, you need to kill all of them, because as you can see by the flashing door, if you don't kill all of them, this door will stay closed. So this is a kill all enemies to unlock doors kind of room. Hey, a green door. The green door we cannot open quite yet, and for good reason. We're in a mini-boss fight right now. And this guy is quite annoying, because he uses a lot of these spores in order to try to kill us. What we need to do is wait for him to open up. Because its shell is too hard, there's nothing we can do. Our power beam and missiles do nothing to its shell. But if he opens up, we can hit the softer inside with missiles, or just regular power beam. That also works, of course. But the missiles do more damage, of course, or this fight will go by quicker. Ow. Yeah, the strategy I usually use with this guy is stay in this corner in morph ball form and only come out of it to hit this guy or to hit its spores to refill your missiles or your energy. Because we can hit the spores for goodies. And just wait for him to open up, then exit your morph ball mode and hit this guy. That's the strategy you're going to want to go for here. Because if you're in morph ball form here, he will never hit you. The early phase of this boss fight is not really necessary. He's quite easily avoided right now, as you can see. He does not move all that fast. But if we hit him enough times, like here, you see, he starts moving really fast. Right now, he becomes a lot harder to avoid. You can also stay at the door to avoid him, but it is easier to do it from this ledge, because he has a tendency to open up pretty high up. And if he does that, you can't reach him easily if you're at the door, so it's better to stay on this ledge. It's basically the best way to deal with this guy. And it's just a matter of waiting until he dies. It does take quite a number of hits. The darker he becomes, the closer he is to dying, if that is not obvious. That's basically how that works. There's a lot of Nintendo games that use that concept. Of bosses becoming darker when they have more damage. But anyway, eventually he will go. He will wither up, you might say, and he becomes a platform. Yeah, that's the whole reason we killed that guy, because we need to use him as a platform. Silly game. Let's just continue. Don't worry, there is still a reward for this guy. It's not just for continuation. But the reward is a little bit further on. We fall down a very large corridor. And find ourselves another Chozo statue. Don't worry, this one won't attack us. And we get the super missile. Select the super missile icon and press the X button to fire them. We get a new type of missile. As you can see, 5 of them come equipped with this first power-up, and this is actually a much more powerful missile. One super missile is the equivalent of 5 missiles. Super powerful. And actually required to use in some instances. And the first one is coming up quite soon. Don't worry, it's not just an enemy weapon to kill bosses or enemies quicker. It also has some uses in the overworld. Stop killing me. This being one of them. These green doors are actually opened with super missiles. And these guys in the ceiling are there to indicate that the super missile, whenever it impacts, also has kind of a earthquake effect. It knocks everything off the ceiling whenever you use it. Oh, and here's the second use of them. Super missile blocks. Whenever you get a block that looks like this, with a super missile icon on it, only the super missile can destroy it. So, our way out of this place is the tutorial of this game showing us how the super missiles are used. Pretty funny, actually, giving us that block and the door. Okay, here at the bottom of the pink room, we're back in the pink room, by the way, you get a free missile expansion. Nothing you have to do for this missile expansion. But that's not all we can find here. These blocks look suspicious, right? That's because they're bombable. Let's get in here and find ourselves the next upgrade immediately. Another Chozo statue, which gives us our first beam upgrade, the charge beam. The charge beam does what you may expect of it. The power beam we can now charge. If we hold the shooting button, we can actually charge ourselves a powerful shot, making the power beam a little bit stronger. It basically becomes as strong as a missile, you might say. Okay, the next stop is going to be to that room over there. Yeah, I'm kind of pointing towards the screen right now. I know you can't really see it, but I'll have an arrow ready for you, so you will see it on screen. Really handy to have that map around. But that is where we're going. And on the way there, we will, of course, pick up a couple of goodies. Okay, let's use our bump jump in order to get in here. This is the first instance of the bump jump being required. Letting a morph ball bump explode while you are still in morph ball form above it, and you can jump upwards with it. There's something up there, but there's nothing we can do there, so let's ignore that for now. There's a pipe over there that looks suspicious. There's a reason for that. There's actually something in there. Let's grind on you guys. And let's wall jump our way up here. Yeah, wall jumping is a thing in this game. If you hug a wall and you jump while holding the opposite direction, you can actually wall jump in this game. And you can use that little trick to get this missile expansion early. You might say this is a little bit of a sequence break. I don't really consider this a sequence break, because the wall jump is a valuable technique in this game, but you are technically you're supposed to get this whenever you get the high jump. In order to jump higher, then you can reach that. You can get it now with the wall jump, so might as well. Okay, you can open and close these gates by shooting them. This one has a blue button, so a simple power beam shot is enough to open them. They will come in different colors, so other means are required to open them up. This one is simply blue, just like the blue doors. They open up with a simple power beam. Don't shoot your spikes at me. I'm getting enough of that crap in Mario Maker 2 whenever people use flying spinies. There's spike shooting. One of the least interesting mechanics, I think. And I don't like them here either. Okay. This is important. Run here, because as you can see, if you don't run, this will happen. This is a crumble floor. So if you don't run, you will fall through the floor. But if you run, holding the B button is how you run, you can actually reach that. There's a little bit of a tutorial of running in this game. We'll be using it more often later. Don't worry, this is just to introduce us to it. Okay, welcome to the red corridor, or the red shaft, sorry. This is the red shaft, what I always call it. Yeah, I have a little bit of nicknames for certain rooms in Metroid games. This one being one of them. We can technically go up here if we wall jump our way up here. But we actually get stuck here because there's a couple of these enemies flying around, which are really hard to avoid if you start wall jumping up here. So this is basically a dead end. Don't go up here. Instead, we want to go down the red shaft. Let's open up. Oh, this is for power bomb. Sorry. We need to go. Where is my... Oh, there we go. I knew we could go down further. The map does not show we can go down further, but we definitely can. This is the way we get to that area, which is on the map. You can see the blue rooms to the right now. That corridor was hidden on our map. And here we find another recharge station, but this one is actually for energy. Whenever you find these kinds of recharge stations, they refill your energy. And that is pretty handy to have. But anyway, let's continue our way to our destination. Here we find some water, and as you can see, the water hinders our movement. We can no longer jump high, and we can no longer run if we're in the water. So don't fall in the water. As you may know from the previous Metroid game, there's something... Oh, dang it. Don't grab me. No, I'm not your snack. Before we continue, we want to go up here. It's pretty obvious there's something up here, because of that little block missing. And if we go in here... Be careful of this place, because as you can see, there's a trap here, making you fall down again. Wait for the block to respawn. And then we can go over to find ourselves a green door. Remember, super missiles to open those. And we find ourselves the next upgrade for our beam, the spacer beam. The spacer beam actually widens our shot. We no longer have one single shot. We now have three shots whenever we fire. One going the same way it went before, but also a shot above and under it, making our shot more powerful. But more on that next time, because I see my time is up. So, see you guys for the next episode tomorrow, when we will continue our quest across Zebes. Treecks out.